So at this point, all the categories and its respective subcategories are created. So let's just view them and verify them. So select the option display over here and press enter and select all items. So you can see that there are 5 primary categories and remaining are subcategories. So at this point we have created groups and we have created the categories for stock items, but the actual stock items are to be created yet. So now next step would be to create stock items, and then we will put them into its respective groups and we will assign a category to it. So now keep pressing the escape key until you reach the inventory main menu. So over here, navigate to the option stock items and press enter and select create, which is under single stock item. Now let's create the first product. It's a laptop from Lenovo. And its model number is so it's a good practice to suffix your product with the model name, because Tally won't accept same name for the product. So I cannot create two products with the same name as Lenovo IdeaPad 330. So if there is another laptop which is also a IdeaPad 330, then you can differentiate that product with this with the model number, because two products would probably have different model number. Now press the enter key to navigate to the next field. Again, in the alias you can provide an alternate name. So since this is an optional field, I will leave it blank. In the field description, you can provide a short description about the product. So you can add information like this product comes with a 7th generation i3 processor and it is equipped with 1 terabyte of hard disk, and it comes with a DOS operating system, and press enter. In the field under, you need to specify the group for this product. So the appropriate group would be Lenovo laptops, and you can select the group from the list of groups present over here, or you can simply type the name of the group. So it is always better to select the subgroup whenever you need to specify the group of a product. So I will select the group as Lenovo laptops. In the field category, you need to specify the category of this product. So we know that this product comes with an i3 processor, and assume that it also comes with 4 GB of installed RAM. So in that case, the appropriate category would be and i3 with 4 GB of RAM. So select the category and press enter. And in the field units, you need to specify the units in which you are going to buy and sell these products. So I'm going to buy and sell these products in units. So navigate to the desired units and select it by pressing the enter key. Alright, so now in the field statutory information, we need to specify whether GST is applicable on this product or not. So yes, GST is going to be applicable on this product, so I'm not going to change the first field over here. And the field set or alter GST details. So if you change this option to yes and press enter, so you would be asked to provide the HSN details and the tax rate for this product. But if you remember, we have already furnished GST related details like HSN code and the rate of GST at group level. So once you define those details at group level, and any product created under such groups would share same details. So we don't have to specify that information again over here. So press the escape key and exit from this screen. And the type of, okay, press the escape key and change this option to no. And the type of supply should be goods for this product, and skip this field rate of duty because we don't have any such information, and press the enter key. So for this field costing method, you need to press the spacebar key to toggle the list. In this field, you need to specify one of these costing methods. So specifying a costing method would determine the price of the goods that Tally needs to consider at the time of calculating profit. So let's take an example. So assume that this product cost 100 rupees, and after 2 days the same product could cost 110 rupees. So we need to tell Tally what price it needs to consider in order to calculate the margin. These are the methods which will determine the cost of your product. For example, if I select the method as FIFO, F-I-F-O, which stands for first in, first out, and its definition is that the product which are purchased first are to be sold first. So assume that I purchase 2 laptops and the first laptop costed me 100 rupees and the second laptop costed me 110 rupees. And then I sold one of the laptops and I sold it for 120 rupees. And if we go by the method first in first out, Tally would mark the first laptop which I purchased as sold. So it will consider the cost price of the laptop as 100 and the selling price is 120 rupees and my net profit would be 20 rupees. And if we specify the costing method as average cost method, then Tally would consider the average of the purchase price of the product as the cost price. For this example, if we have 2 laptops, one is costing 100 rupees and another is costing 110 rupees, then its average cost would be 105 rupees. So at the time of calculating profits, Tally would consider the average cost of the product. So when I sell the product for 120 rupees, my profit would be 15 rupees if we go by the method average cost. And if we go by the method first in first out, so it will consider the cost price of first product, which is 100 rupees at the time of calculating the profit. So in that case, my profit would be 20 rupees. And if we go by the method last in first out, so its definition says that the product which is purchased last would be the first to be sold. So in this case, if I sell a laptop, then Tally would consider the price of the last purchased laptop, which is 110 rupees, and my net profit would be 10 rupees because I sold the laptop for 120 rupees and I bought it for 110 rupees. So this is how the costing method works. You can select a costing method according to your needs, and I want you to do a simple search on the costing methods, so that will provide more information as to what costing method is suitable according to your business needs and supply and demand and all those things. So right now I will retain the costing method as average cost method, which is the default costing method, and press enter. The market valuation method will determine the worth of your stock which is lying in your inventory. So there may be cases where the price of a product may increase or decrease. So these methods would determine the true worth of your products. So if you go by the average price market valuation method, then the market value of that product would be the average of the cost of the products. And if I select the market valuation method as last sale price, then the market value of that product would be the price at which it was sold last. For example, if I have a product which costed me rupees 10 and I sold it for rupees 12, so according to the valuation method last sell price, that product would be valued at rupees 12. And in case if the price of the product is falling and I decide to sell it at a lower price, for example, I decide to sell it at 9 rupees, then the market value of that product would be 9 rupees. The reason why we evaluate the market value of a product is to arrive at the true worth of the product. At the end of the financial year, we calculate the value of closing stock, and we use this market valuation methods to know the true worth of the products. So suppose at the end of the year, if you find out that the value of your inventory is more than what you have paid for, then you can consider it as a benefit. And in case if the market value of your product is declining, then you can take crucial measures to avoid loss. So this is how market valuation is useful. So for this field, I will select the default average price method and select it. So at this point, all the required information to create the stock is entered, and you can press Ctrl A or you can keep pressing the Enter key until Tally prompts you to accept the item creation. So press Y to accept the item creation. Now let me create a stock item for a printer. So it is of HP brand. And its group would be HP printer. And its category would be a color cartridge printer. And I'm going to sell it in units. So I'll select the type of the unit. So I need not to enter this information, and I will keep the costing method and market valuation methods to the default values and create the stock. Now let me create a stock item for ink cartridge. So it is of HP brand, and provide a short description. And its category would be color ink. And I'm going to sell this as a pack of 3 pieces. So the appropriate unit would be pack of 3 pieces. So I will select it. And the reporting unit quantity code. In this field, I need to specify one of these unit quantity codes, which will be used to report the quantity of supply at the time of filing the GST return. So whether I want to furnish my quantity of supply in packs or in pieces, I can select it over here. So for this item, I'm going to report its supply in packs. So I'll select the unit quantity code as pack. And I don't want to change the remaining options. And in the field for opening balance, so you can specify the quantity of stock which is already present with you. So in case if you are moving from manual accounting to computerized accounting, and if you have information about the quantity of available stock, then you can specify it over here. So suppose if I have 10 packs of this item, then I can specify its quantity over here and specify its purchase rate and specify the unit, whether it is pack or pieces. So this is useful when you want to record opening stock for an item. So right now I'm not going to specify any details over here, and I'll just accept the item creation. So at this point I have created enough stock items which will be used to record its purchase and sales. So let's view them. Press the escape key to exit from item creation screen and select the option display, which is under multiple stock items, and select the option all items. So these are the stock items which we created, and we will use these stock items to record its purchase and its sales. In the next section we will record purchase and sales of these items along with its GST component. So you will learn how to record GST entries, and you will learn how to record purchase and sales of these items as well.